Good morning again from Goa.
Good morning. If you are just tuning in, we are Two Roving Hearts. I'm Jasmine and he's Beer Blogger. We're also Jasmine and Ajay. And we are very happy to have you back with us in beautiful sunny Goa.
After that rough day traveling up to Goa, which you just saw.
And then a lovely restful day.
We had an amazing time at Club Mahindra. We slept like babies. Like I knocked off.
It was just what the doctor ordered. It's what we needed. It was a full rest day and that's exactly what we had.
We are at Club Mahindra Varca Resort. And this is a very, very beautiful property.
It's one of our favorite Club Mahindra properties actually. We come here almost every year or every 2 years at least once.
Yeah, it's huge. It's
comfortable.
The landscaping is beautiful. The architecture is beautiful.
The rooms are beautiful and they're so comfortable. They just make you feel relaxed.
These are all individual. There's one main hotel building, but they're all individual bungalows. Mm-hmm. And each of the bungalows has its 1 BHK studios and 2 BHK apartments. We are currently in a studio.
Right. And it's Jasmine, actually one of the biggest studios that we've stayed at so far.
Yeah. Jasmine will shortly give you a room tour.
Yeah.
And other than that, this property has a lot for everyone. You know,
a lot of things.
For people who are coming with their kids. They have a lot of activities. There are 2 swimming pools. And
a spa. There's a gym. And there's even an entire activity center which is near the beach for children. Some buggy rides, four-wheel, the ATV type of rides. Lots of things for children to do and keep them busy and keep them happy and entertained. There's stuff on the beach. Later on we'll try and take you and show you how beautiful that white sand beach is. And there's a lovely restaurant here. The food is good and there are nearby beaches where you can go for dinner or lunch to shacks.
All in all, a beautiful place. It just feels amazing. Goa feels even better when you're when we are at least at this place. And I'm sure there are plenty of other beautiful places around. So wherever you are, Goa is beautiful. So we got up pretty late and then we decided, okay, you know what? We are going to go to one of our favorite restaurants, Longuinhos. So
by pretty late, he means 9 o'clock.
Okay, 10-ish was more like the reality.
So we skipped breakfast yesterday because there's this one place in Margao City where it's an iconic Margao institution. It's called Longuinhos and it's very, very popular with the locals and with tourists as well because it's got the most authentic, beautiful Goan food. We are just heading out for some lunch. It's a place that we really love going to and I can't wait to show you guys what we're going to be eating. We're going to be eating some Goan specialties and Aju is super excited about this meal, right Aju?
Oh, beautiful. It's an institution in Margao.
All set?
All set. Follow along.
Hey, do you need a lift?
Guys, we are at this place called Longuinhos. It's right in the heart of Margao City. It's next to the municipal gardens. You can ask anyone about it. It is an institution in itself. We love this place. Serves the best Goan food in Margao. Let's go and have some fun.
We're here at Longuinhos and we've just seen that there is a book of recipes available. This is written by one of the owners and it seems awesome. I think I'm definitely picking this up because I love me some Goan food. We are just ready to order. We are getting ourselves some awesome cashew fenny with some lemonade and we're starting on with some masala papad with prawns and some squid batter fry. So that's just going to be the start of our meal because we're really hungry. We've skipped breakfast just for this meal and can't wait to get going.
Hello,
we were in for a surprise. So we were served this this pork dish.
Okay.
And we thought it was the one that we had ordered, the pork armas. But apparently we were told the owner of this restaurant, I think Mr. Iva Coutinho, he prepared this to take it home for himself and then just gave us a little bit for tasting. I mean guys, this can only happen in Goa. This is fantastic. Somebody preparing something to take home and then offering it to you for tasting. Where else have you heard of this? It's like unbelievable.
Spicy
but it's so yum, so tender and perfectly balanced.
Just,
oh,
I can't stop.
And now we've got our regular main course. This is the pork hummus and this is sorpotel.
This is a dish we never miss when we come to Longuinhos. Absolutely out of this world, and you can order it either with rice or with buns.
Dipping it into the sopper then. Heavenly.
We are having such a good time at Longuinhos. The meal so far has been fantastic. Oh my god, we dream of this food every time we're in Bombay. I wish there were a Longuinhos in Bombay. May this happen. Look at demolishing this food. Look at it, it's already half empty.
Very full now. That's so good. Goan food at its best.
So if I had to pick a winner, for me obviously the homemade pork hummus which Iva Coutinho shared with us. Thank you so much, we really appreciate it. I think that has to be the winner over here. All due respect to the cook, the sorpotel is also dynamite. It's absolutely awesome. And even the restaurant's pork hummus is damn good. It's a very strong flavor. But overall, this meal has been so, so good. Guys, if you like Goan food and if you like non-veg, come to Longuinhos. It is the best place. You can't miss it in Margao. It's in the center of Margao near the park. Just come here. No hesitation. That, my friends, was one epic meal.
I want bed.
Ajay want bed. Because we have eaten. We have eaten bed. So much that he just wants to go to sleep. Since we got out of the restaurant, all Ajay has said is bed.
Bed.
We are so full. And we had such a good time. We topped our meal off with a caramel custard. It was just awesome.
Divine.
But nothing can beat that entire meal, and especially the homemade preparation.
Right now, bed.
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 Blowin, okay, horn, guys. Blowin horn. BLOIN. Hi.
Okay, so you guys just saw what a fabulous place Longuinhos is, and we really, really enjoy it. And as you can see, after that, after the food, all I could think of was a bed to sleep. So Jas, you want to take them on a small room tour? We are staying in a studio, so it's going to be really small.
You can see all the different places, and I'm already talking in that video, so you guys will get to see our room. Enjoy. Right, so we are going to take you in for our room tour. We have a gorgeous balcony here with two seating spaces, and you can see the view that we have is absolutely gorgeous. We're very close to the second main pool, and the water features right in front of us. And I will take you a pretty short, quick tour. So that's our sofa seating area. This is a studio room, so it can be pulled out to make a bed for one more person. That is a lovely king-size bed, which is absolutely divine. And look, they always have a surprise for us. What a cute piggy. Is that a cute piggy or a sheep? I can't tell. It's just so cute, the way they've done it. Aww. I love it. Here we have a small coffee table, a TV, dressing table. We got a little bit of a kitchenette happening here with a microwave, some plates, spoons, The room comes with tea and coffee. And we have a wardrobe space here. Nice wardrobe space. We've got a bit of a dressing area here. And a suite and a simple bathroom with toilet. Very functional and very relaxing. Look at Ajay, he's about to just crash.
So, as you can see, just beautiful Club Mahindra. After that amazing meal, we found the bed, which I was so craving.
And we just relaxed for the rest of the afternoon.
Yeah, and then I think after that, we went for a little bit of a dip in the pool.
Yeah, we actually set out on a stroll. We thought, oh, this will be a nice evening for a walk. We're too tired to swim or do anything athletic. We're heading to the pool, guys, just to sit and chill out for a while. We've had a nice nap and now all we want to do is just sit and vegetate for a while. We have had a really nice day so far and it calls for some more relaxation. So we've just headed to the poolside. You can take a look at the pool behind me. That is a gorgeous main pool area. And there is Ajay also vlogging. And we are just gonna sit and chill out now, guys. We're not gonna do much for the rest of the day, but we are gonna go to Pedros.
So Club Mahindra always makes sure that they have certain activities as well as things that thrill the taste buds. They have this awesome looking chaat counter, which is in a hathgadi shape or a cart shape. And they've got some assortment of, I think, curd.
And the pool just called to us. We came back to our room, changed and went back for a swim.
That was funny. We reached the pool and we're like, okay, I don't know. We're going to sit there for a bit. And the minute we saw the water,
it was so tempting.
Like, oh dear. Let's go change and come and
so that's what we did. Okay, so we couldn't resist it. So we are heading in to the pool area. Because we went near the water and it was absolutely divine. So both he and me, who are super tired, said, chuck it, it's looking too good, let's go. Let's go for a swim.
And I dipped a wee bit of my toe in it and it was not too cold.
Not too cold, and warm. The weather was just perfect. Right. It's going to be a good swim.
Yeah.
It's not that cold, why don't you come in? So Club Mahindra has two pools. One is in the main building area, which is right on the other side. And this pool is my favorite because this pool has jets. It has water jets which you can go and sit at and just chill and get a relaxing massage. And they have certain activities both for kids and for adults here. So you can see this big ass dog over here. This is something new that we've not seen before here. You can go and for 200 rupees plus tax, you can go as an adult into the zorb and water zorb. Feel like a hamster, enjoy yourself. It's a good relaxing way to spend an afternoon, guys. Even an evening, the weather is lovely. Ajay, come in, come on in. And as soon as it started getting a little nippy and cold, we said let's just head back and change up and then get ready for dinner. Swim all done. Both of us are feeling fresh.
Yep.
Guys, that was such a lovely swim and it's getting chilly now, so we are planning to head back in, change up so that we can go out again. We have a beautiful sunset behind us. I don't know if you can see it, but it was really a lovely, just what we needed to freshen up, and now we're good to have a nice shower and head out again.
We came back, we relaxed for a bit,
we watched Netflix.
Sadly, we watched
for an hour. We couldn't resist.
We watched Netflix and then off we went to another favorite of ours.
Yeah.
So it's a shack on Benaulim Beach called Pedros. Another place that we recommend if you are in this part of Goa, that is the Varca Benaulim area.
So we are all set, guys, for dinner. We've had a nice swim. We've had a nice relaxing day. And we're going to head to this place called Pedros, which is in a neighboring beach called Benaulim. So we are staying at Varca Beach, which is in South Goa. And Benaulim is just one beach above us. But it's got some amazing restaurants on the beach and off the beach, like a little cafe called Lina's. But today we are going to Pedros for some authentic Goan food.
Aju and me can't get enough of authentic local cuisine, so let's head and let's see what we can get there.
It's so lovely here and it's so romantic, especially if you want to go for a late night walk around the premises or an evening walk on the beach. It's really great, guys. We are here at Benaulim Beach. This is our second favorite beach in Goa. The first being, of course, Varca, where we stay every year. And Benaulim is the place we come to eat and for fun and life. And it's a beautiful beach with beautiful places, great food. We'll take you on in and we'll show you around, show you Pedros and get some good food.
It's a place where local Goans frequent a lot,
yeah,
especially on their special occasions like a birthday
or an anniversary.
Like that.
Yeah.
Friday, Saturday, Sunday, they do have live music, sometimes karaoke.
And we've been there when they've had live music, and it's good fun. People start dancing, and it's just great.
Fine. Oh, we had something. You want to talk about prawn wafers and what they're like?
Oh my goodness. Okay, so there are these little wafers which we can't resist, and you'll get these at really good restaurants which have Goan food. They're called prawn wafers, and they'll give you a big little bucket of these wafers, and they've got pink edges in a white center, and they just have this slight flavor of prawn, which is beautiful. I mean, if you're a non-vegetarian, try this, guys. You will love it.
And it was just perfect. We arrived there on the beach, you could hear the waves.
They were playing nice 80s music,
80s
and 90s music when we were growing up. So I had a gin and tonic and he had another Cashew Fenny. And then we ordered what is supposed to be the restaurant's main dish, which is a shark ambotik. Honestly, I've had a better shark ambotik at that restaurant. So maybe it was the regular chef's night off yesterday. But yeah, it's good for Goan food and it's a good place on the beach to go for lunch, dinner or snacks. We will continue letting you know about our recommendations. We'll put in links and locations in the description below.
If you're enjoying the videos, then hit the like button and let us know. And hit the subscribe button to stay in touch and be notified about our videos.
And definitely leave us some comments, guys. We love it when you guys do that. It gives us a chance to have a conversation with you guys, and it encourages us to keep going and showing you all the beautiful places that we're traveling.
But
yes, one second. Sorry, that was a little off topic.
I feel like we've been talking for half an hour.
Yeah, me too.